Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. A short video for you today, showing you how to insert your own vertical navigation restriction into the flight plan. Why may you want to do this? Well, a number of reasons, but in today's scenario, we're flying an approach into London Luton. You see we've got the full approach here that we're flying on the navigation display depicted. But we could, for example, say VATSIM of controllers have gone offline, there's no traffic around. We may want to go direct to the final approach course, but we want to get down there sensibly and fly a managed descent. And as a general rule of thumb, we want to be at flight level 100 at a speed of 250 knots at 30 miles from the aerodrome. And that allows us to be able to shoot any approach from any direction sensibly without having to make drastic changes to vertical speed and so forth. So in order to do that, we need to get up our range ring. So we'd select a line selector fix on the left. We'll go to fix info here on the right, and we would put Echo Golf Golf Whiskey into the reference fix, and we'll put in our radius of 30 here, the left key select, and that should draw that onto the navigation display. So there's 30 miles on that, around London Luton Airport. So that means at this point here where we intersect, we want to be at flight level 100 and 250 knots. Now if we're going direct, so we'll now go direct to the final approach fix. So obviously on the approach we've got a bit more time to get down. We don't necessarily need to be there, so at this point really just after that it's 150 on this, flying all this. So we're going in a shortcut and we'd probably want to get down a bit faster. So we go to the directory page, that's the top left button there, and we'd find the final approach fix, which is Charlie Fox 07 in this case. We'll insert that. Now we're going direct. So you can see now the point on the map where we want to be at flight level 100 and 250 knots. So we need to put that in. So how do we do that? Quite simply, we'd go back to the fix info page and we'd repress that radius button there on 30, and that would draw us a waypoint there. We need to be in heading select before we put that waypoint in. The computer will remind you that. So if I try to insert that now, it should say you need to go into heading mode. There you go, select heading track first. So we pull heading, we insert that, we should go back into nav, up that, get an intercept. But basically now we've got that waypoint in, so 30 miles from London Luton, and we can put our restrictions in. So we go to on the flight plan page, 30 DME Echo Golf Golf Whiskey here on the left is the fix. And if you right select that, that's the moment we're going to be there at flight level 10.8, so 10,800. We can put a constraint in there, flight level 100 and 250 knots, in insert, and if we put flight level 100 in here, we manage descent, and if we, that's on track. So we went direct now to that point, that's back on course, so we're in nav. We're going manage descent, and it's going to get us down to flight level 100 at that fix, hopefully. We've got enough space to do it. And there you go, that's how you'd use that. So you have to have your track intercepting that radius in order to be able to do this. So that's important to remember. That range ring we saw earlier, your track has to basically run through that range ring to allow you to put that fix in. So that's how you... So we're approaching that point now. Flight level 100, the speed's come back there to meet the restriction. It's depicted there, so that will idle the throttles out a little bit over because we didn't allow ourselves enough time in regards to inserting that. But if you had more time during the cruise and you're planning for that, that's how you do it. So that is inserting a vertical restriction using the radius function from the airport. Hope you found that useful. Any comments or questions on that, drop them in chat. And please like and subscribe, and look out for the next one. Thanks for watching.